Hey, what's up, guys? So this morning what we're doing is we're going to the archery range. Just gonna get some reps in. I haven't shot enough lately. Been busy with work and life and all that good stuff. So we're gonna go, like I said, go to the archery range today and try to see if we can't tighten up the groups a little bit and just have a little fun while we're doing it. So hope you enjoy. So, like I said, what we're doing today, we're just going to do a little shooting. I hadn't really shot my bow in a good little while, so I'm pretty rusty. And it's a good idea at any time you get a chance just to sling a couple of arrows, try to keep your muscle memory where it's supposed to be and all that, anchor points. But let's face it, I'm nowhere near professional. I just enjoy shooting my bow, and I enjoy being in the woods, so let's do some shooting. All right, got the GoPro set up down there. Let's send a couple down. Not bad. It is a little bit high. I know I bumped this thing the other day when I was pulling it up into my stand. I bumped the sight right on one of the steps, which shouldn't affect it, but like I said, I'm gonna say this a lot. I am not a professional archer by any means. I guess you could consider me a hobbyist. I think it's fun. And I like to try to get better at it. And I've always been a big hunter, so it just fits. It looks pretty tight. I'm gonna go check it. All right, so not the tightest group I've ever had, but I'll take it. Like I said, there's a lot of weak spots in these targets. So I could tell this hadn't been hit much, so I'm aiming for the target in the O in Morrell. In my setup today, what I'm using is I've got the Matthews V3X 29. I'm using the Trophy Ridge 4-pin sight. I got the Matthews integrated rest, using Easton Axis 5mm arrows, 300s, and I just got a 100 grain field tip on my release. I came from using an index release for years, but I recently picked up this UV button. Been wanting to get into a thumb release for a while, but none really kind of stood out. This one stood out. I love the way it feels. Just feels more substantial in my hand, so we'll send another one down. Looks pretty good. Send another one down. That one looks pretty tight. Send one more. I'm only shooting three at a time because I've been out of it for a while. I don't want to burn myself out. That looks pretty tight too. Not gonna complain. All right, so now what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be shooting from an elevated platform. They do, that's one of the good things about Wetumpka's archery places. They do have, you know, flat shooting, and then they have a couple of targets set out for elevated shooting. And I mean, there's no better practice than the real thing. So we're gonna do a couple errors with that. All right, we've made it up here to the platform. It's kind of nice up here. It's a long way. All right, I'm gonna shoot probably one more quiver. My battery's going dead on my camera. But I got something funky going on with my bow here. Now that I'm shooting from elevated, it's shooting way off. I'm gonna just shoot again and make sure it wasn't just me, because I'm sure it is. We're gonna see. See, that one was kind of aiming right where I was going. Oops, I'm dropping air off. See, these steps will get you. We're probably 20, 25 foot up in the air right now. That one looked decent. Actually, that was a little low. Yeah, they're both low, which I'm aiming a little low for the drop, but sit one more. Send one more. Looks like about the same. We'll be right back. So anyways, thanks for watching. If you enjoy stuff like this, go ahead and like the video, maybe leave a comment or subscribe, whatever. Like I said, I hope you enjoy it. We'll see you next time. Thanks.